Hey there guys, what's happening? Mike Davison here, and in this video I'm going to make some comparisons between life in Phuket and Koh Samui, two of the most popular islands in Thailand. So if you're thinking about visiting either of those two islands, Phuket or Koh Samui, this video is going to be super helpful for you. And if you're new to the channel, guys, and you want to see more of my content each and every single week, don't forget to hit that subscribe button for more regular videos about life in Thailand as an expat. So let's get into it. The difference of life in Koh Samui and Phuket. And really the first point that I want to make is there's no better or worse place, you know. Both places are absolutely incredible places to live. And this video isn't about choosing a winner, so to speak. It's really just some observations that I've personally made after living in both places for a while. So just to give you some context, I moved to Phuket the first time in 2012 and spent almost 9 years living there. So I know the island really well. It's an island very close to my heart. And I've recently moved to Koh Samui. I'm living in Lamai now. I moved here at the beginning of August 2021. So I've been here almost 3 months now. And I've got to say, the place is growing on me very quickly. I absolutely love life here. And I can't see myself going anywhere else anytime soon. So let's talk about some of the differences, some of the big differences that I've personally noticed between Phuket and Koh Samui. And the first one is the roads. So the roads in Phuket and Koh Samui are very different. Phuket has hectic roads, straight up with you guys. There are big four-lane highways, there's big intersections, 200 second waits on the traffic lights, you know, there's underpasses, there's big circles or roundabouts, which can prove very interesting to navigate. So that the road infrastructure, if you will, in Phuket is kind of like that of a big city, you know. There's always work on roads, there's big four-lane highways, big bypasses. And driving in Phuket, if you haven't got experience of Thai roads, it can be pretty hectic, so make sure you get a helmet on if you are driving a motorbike. I've heard far too many sad stories over the years, so that's really important, guys. Wherever you're driving in Thailand, get a helmet on your head. Not in case the police catch you, in case you have an accident. Now, the roads here in Koh Samui are very different. A lot smaller. I haven't seen any big four-lane highways. The only traffic lights that I've seen are not working or dotting orange all the time, which means you can just pass through them. There's no underpasses. I've only seen a couple of circles or roundabouts. And in general, the roads are a lot less quieter than in Phuket. But at the same time, there's quite a lot of potholes. It's more like driving on an island road system than it is in Phuket. So the roads here in Samui, a lot smaller, seems to be a lot less traffic, a lot less cars, more people on motorbikes than in Phuket. So in general, the roads in Samui, less developed, less road infrastructure than in Phuket. So the second point that I want to make is the beaches. Now, both places have absolutely incredible beaches. If you want to live the beach life, Phuket won't disappoint you. Koh Samui definitely won't disappoint you. But the main difference that I've noticed about the beaches themselves is here in Koh Samui, there seems to be more on the beach. Okay, I'm talking like villas on the beach, you know. Go over to Mae Nam and there's some beautiful villas, a resort smack bang on the beach. There's lots of beach bungalows on the beach, you know. You can step out and put your feet into the sand, quite literally. So there's restaurants on the beach. So this in Koh Samui is one thing that I noticed that Phuket doesn't really have so much of. You can find those places, sure, if you look in the Cape Panwar area and places like that, you can find more stuff on the beach. But in general, the big beaches in Phuket, Patong, Surin, Katar, Karon, most things are set back across the road. You've got a sidewalk just behind the beach, and most of the restaurants, resorts, and hotels are set back from the beach. You do get a couple of small beach clubs, maybe in Kamalar Beach, but in general, there's a lot more clubs and restaurants and villas and resorts on the beach here in Samui. It's not really a plus or a minus, a pro or a con, it's just an observation that I've made from living in both places. So that's the second one, the beaches. And the third one is shopping. So Phuket is pretty well equipped as far as shopping's concerned. A lot of big malls, although some of them have closed now due to the recent events, due to COVID-19. Junt Salon in Patong is now closed. But there are several central festivals in Phuket. Lots of big brand name shops. There's a sort of a brand discount center up at the top of the bypass road where you can go and buy Adidas and Nike and all of those big brands. Now, here in Samui, those sort of things are less available. There's less brand names. There's one central festival in Sha Wang where you can get most things, you know, but it's a smaller central festival than in Phuket. So you're more equipped for shopping in Phuket. Koh Samui, things are a little bit limited. There's only a couple of places that I've found where you can buy Western food and things such as that. I mean, supermarkets that sell Western food in Phuket, you've got a lot more choice as far as shopping is concerned. So good thing for me, I guess, is I don't really like shopping too much, so it doesn't bother me. But if you are looking for a shopping holiday, which I know a lot of people are, a lot of people like to go get deals when they're in Thailand, Phuket's going to be a better option for you on that one, if you're looking for brand names, etc. So that's the third one, shopping. The fourth one on the list is the general busyness of the place and how many people are around. Now, obviously, the whole of Thailand is significantly quieter than it was a couple of years ago when there were lots of tourists coming here. Now, when I was in the Phuket sandbox, although it was quieter, there was still a lot of life around town, you know. Phuket has a large local Thai population. You go into Phuket town and the place is still bustling. You go into the middle of Shalong, the place is still bustling. Sure, the tourist areas are certainly quieter than they were, but there's still quite a bit of life in Phuket. Now, here in Samui, sure, there's still life, but in general, there's less people around, you know. You go into a restaurant and quite often, you're the only person sitting there. Now, the Samui sandbox has attracted a lot less people than the Phuket sandbox. So I think partly that's the reason for it. There's less tourists here in Samui. The local population is smaller. Geographically, the island is smaller as well. So the busyness of Koh Samui, it's a lot less busy than Phuket is. Now that has pros and cons. Obviously it's not a good thing for the local economy. However, there's loads of deserted beaches. Rent prices are pretty low right now here in Samui. So it does have its plus sides if you're a tourist and you enjoy tranquility and quiet beaches, which I personally love. So that's the difference in the busyness of the place. And the last one is more of a general point, summing it up, is the way of life, yeah? The way people are living here and the way life feels. Now, for me, I loved living in Phuket, don't get me wrong, I absolutely love the place, but living in Phuket is kind of like living in a big city with loads of amazing beaches dotted around, yeah? Almost like somewhere like Barcelona, you know? There's everything that you need that a big city has and amazing beaches. Now, here in Samui, it feels more like island life. It's more sleepy. You're never 2 minutes away from a sea view. You can always see the sea pretty much here in Koh Samui, even if you're on the mountain road. In Phuket, it's more hectic. It's more busy. The pace of life seems faster than here in Samui. Here in Samui, it's really got that sleepy, relaxed, chilled out island vibe, which Phuket doesn't really have. I mean, Phuket gets a little bit of a bad rap from a lot of people that I speak to. It's the party zone. You get a lot of negative people there, is what a lot of people think. But I do defend that. I mean, there's some amazing places in Phuket. I lived many, many happy years there. But it's true to say that Samui feels more like island living, you know? Very relaxed, very slow, the traffic here is island style, the beaches here are definitely a lot cleaner than in Phuket, a lot less busy, so the way of life in Samui is definitely more relaxed and downbeat than Phuket, if you will. So those are my five comparisons between life in Phuket and life in Samui. And let me know, guys, if you have visited both islands, do you agree with me? Do you disagree with me? Let me know in the comments, guys. I always love reading them. And if you would like to connect with me personally and other expats and digital nomads in Thailand, you can join my free Facebook group, Thailand Expats and Digital Nomads. There's a link to join that group in the description of this video. With that said, guys, I hope you took value from this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And as always, I'll see you in the next one.